My name is Ag. I'm a programmer. Somehow you found this video. Maybe because you're interested in learning Clojure or a Racket or maybe Emacs Lisp or maybe Fennel. Perhaps you've never done any Lisp programming before. Maybe you watched Rich Hickey videos like Simple Made Easy, or maybe you read some of the essays by Paul Graham. Or watched a talk from Strange Loop Conference and decided to explore Elisp. And I want to tell you about a couple of probably the most important things for your journey. Let's get to it. First, let's talk about structure. What is a Lisp structure? The basic unit of a Lisp program is a symbolic expression. So what the heck is a symbolic expression? If you go to a Wikipedia page and it says here, in computer programming, S expression or symbolic expression is an expression in a like name notation for nested list. Okay? S expressions are just lists. And you can probably remember Lisp stands for list processing. So anything within a pair of parentheses in Lisp is an S expression. Now, let's try to write some code that explains this more. I'm going to assume that you don't know Lisp at all. Maybe you know a little, but let me explain it for those who don't. Instead of writing some Lisp code and trying to explain what it does, let me pick some snippet in a non-Lispy language, something that any programmer can understand. So this is intro to JSX page from React. In this little snippet, it's absolutely straightforward. Let's write the equivalent of this code, but in a Lisp dialect. Let's write it in Clojure script. Okay. Now, without trying to mentally parse and understand this little snippet, let's first talk about editing Lisp programs. First of all, these are all S expressions. Okay. Everything within a pair of parentheses in Lisp is a symbolic expression. Some Lisp dialects, like Clojure, also include square brackets and curly braces, as you can see, but there are two S expressions. This is an S expression, this is an S expression, and this one is S expression. So editing a program in a Lisp is mainly about moving S expressions around, right? So I can grab this one and move somewhere else, right? Or undo, anything. I can grab this one and move, and so on and so forth, right? First thing you may notice, S expressions are always like the parentheses come in pairs. The parentheses should be always balanced. If you have an opening paren, there always have to be a closing paren, right? Square brackets, same thing. Okay. Most editor and IDE plugins for programming in Lisp dialects, be that Clojure, Racket, Fennel, Common Lisp, Emacs Lisp, etc., do include features to handle that automatically. Find it, enable it. Now, another aspect of editing Lisp you should know about is called structural editing. Let me show you. There are a number of structural editing commands, and I'll show you the basic ones. So let's say you have a S expression, right? And you have something on the right side of it, foo, bar, zap, right? So now you want to include this thing inside this S expression. How do you do this quickly? For that, there is a structural editing command called slurp. You can boom, boom, right? And you say like, oh, like, but that's just like, I can just copy and paste it. But like, what's great about structural editing commands that they work with structure, and it doesn't matter if the things are on the same line or different lines, they're indented differently. So slurp, slurp, you see that it like takes them. Like similarly, you can slurp from the other side, from the left side, using slurp backward, right? And if you want to kick the one of these out, like, you know, sometimes you like slurp too much, too many symbolic expressions in, so then you have an opposite command for that. It's called barf. So barf this out, and boom, it's out, right? Barf this out, boom, it's out. Slurp, barf, slurp, slurp, barf, barf. Similarly, slurp backwards, barf backwards to work on the left side. Okay, there are other structural editing commands, like for example, transpose. It just changes the order of S expressions, and again, it works like regardless if they are on the same line or different lines. It works within the structure, right? That's why it's called structural editing command. There are more commands. There are more difficult ones, like convolute. There are commands for wrapping, wrapping S expressions, unwrapping them. But you definitely should learn them. Matter of fact, learning them sometimes helps even in non-Lisp languages. Regardless of what IDE or editor you choose to use, you should find a way to perform structural editing, okay? Yeah, I know it would take some time, but eventually your muscle memory kicks in and it just starts feeling very natural. Programming will become like composing music or poetry. It will allow you to move between IDEs, editors, different machines, because you won't have to rely on some complicated mechanisms of code refactoring specific to a single IDE. Now, the second very important thing I want to talk about is called so-called REPL-driven workflow. You've probably heard this term, REPL. REPL stands for Read, Eval, Print, Loop. REPLs exist not only in Lisps, but in other languages as well. But Lisp REPLs are truly different. Let me try to show how. As I said, REPL stands for Read, Eval, Print, Loop. All right. And read phase doesn't mean that the interpreter has to read your program as you type it into the REPL console. That's a very common newbie mistake. When working with a Lisp, you don't have to type things directly into the REPL console. What do you do instead is that you connect to the existing REPL process, and that process could be running locally on your laptop or remotely. And that's just bananas. Imagine debugging a program through a REPL connection, but the program is running a million miles away on a spacecraft. Oh, yeah, I'm not making this up. That's not just a science fiction plot. It actually happened before. Anyway, you connect to the REPL right from your editor, and you evaluate things directly from your editor. Like, I already have established connection. So if I type something like this and say, like, you know, and using the command supplied by Clojure plugin for my editor, I use eval command and I evaluate this symbolic expression, and boom, it gives me results immediately. I can see the results. In other languages, like the Lisp, you have to understand that you see Lisp is unlike many other programming languages. Lisp program is a living, breathing thing. In other languages, the code is kind of dead. You can look at it, you can read it, you can modify it, but until you run it, it stays static. It stays kind of dead. You compose a program, you fix something, and then you run a program. In Lisp, you run the program as you type. You don't have to wait for the linter, for the compiler, for linker, then finally for the execution of the program. In Lisp, you type something and you can eval that right away. That's, in essence, is the basics of REPL-driven programming. You should learn this workflow as early as you can when you decide to learn Lisp, because then you wouldn't have to read the code top to bottom to understand everything that your program does. You can simply eval program piecemeal, like eval this, eval this, eval this, and finally this becomes this, right? That's all that I have for you today. I hope this saves you a lot of time and frustration. Happy Lisping.